Bonjour, bonjour, and welcome to Fiction After Lunch. We are back. I'm Mindy.
I got a new message, Dan.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. I'm Sam, hi. I got a little distracted with a second.
And I'm Niola.
Yes, welcome back. We just recorded the last episode, so it's, we already talked a lot, but we are going to talk more.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, welcome. For you, it might have been 2 weeks, or this episode is already out, so you're already listening to it. After you listened to the last episode, I hope it's not your first time completely being here in our podcast, because it would be very bad.
Yeah.
Because we are going to continue reading a story that old Sam wrote,
yep.
Considering a story that small Sam wrote. And there are a lot of characters, a serial killer and a police officer are in love, and yes. And now they are breaking into the house of Mindy and Paula, and one is in the wardrobe and one is in the under the sofa.
Yeah.
And now both of them is coming home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see.
Yep.
We don't have anything to talk about food because we didn't eat anything in between.
Yeah, that's still us. Look at our faces. Oh, Mindy is very angry.
I'm not angry anymore. Now I'm very chill. In the last episode, I was in the beginning a little bit angry, but not because of you.
A little bit angry.
Angry.
Yeah.
I can start talking about our neighbors again. I'm angry.
Neighbor corner.
Neighbor corner, yes. No, yeah. No, I don't have a neighbor corner, man.
Okay, so present Sam.
For heaven's sake, man.
Anyway, continuing a horrible story I wrote when I was very little. And we're connecting it to the story from season one. Yeah.
Perfect.
How was our week since we last spoke? We spoke last a few minutes ago.
Yeah, the last few minutes were great. Really quiet.
Yeah, between recordings, we didn't talk. We didn't make eye contact.
No, we just sat there awkwardly waiting for it to continue.
Yeah.
Just awkwardly while Sam was writing a message to someone else.
Yep.
Yeah.
And we were just like,
all my other friends.
All of my other friends. And we were just like, okay, you're on your phone, now we're also on our phone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just to be a member of the society.
Yeah. Phone society.
It's phone society. Yes, quick fan corner in the nothing 2 minutes. I became a fan of Niona.
Okay, hashtag save our flag means death. I hope this is resolved by the time this episode comes out. If not, I'll be very sad.
Hashtag
sad life. Hashtag sad life, hashtag renew.
Flag means death, season 3.
They don't want to continue the season if I...
No, although it's the most popular show on the network.
Yeah, I heard it.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't understand it. I mean, I haven't watched the series until now. I wanted to watch it at some point, but I also don't understand why.
Yep. How was our lunch? Was good, thank you.
You wrote down these questions. You're like, oh, thank you. Past Sam for asking me. Very nice of you. Do you write letters to your future self?
No.
Or did you at some point wrote something like this kind of diary thing? Where you actually wrote something to your future self or to your past self or anything?
No.
In my thoughts, I sometimes thought about my future self when I was little.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope my future self would have it better than my past self.
Okay.
And I hoped I would make something out of myself as a thank you for making it through and hanging on and not... Yeah.
Why does it always get this dark?
Yeah, sorry.
I'm just asking, why did you ask me? Why is it not possible to ask you a normal question and you go into this random dark tunnel?
This random dark tunnel. randomly appearing.
Which ends in depression and sadness. Nona, I love your table, by the way. I can punch on this table.
It's a nice table. It's like wood, but it's not wood. And I find it very funny.
It's good. Yeah, I like to punch on it and be angry at some. Yeah, because I actually wanted something like this. This is what I want to say.
Yeah.
Because I saw this when I was young. I also thought about my future self, and I wrote actually letters to my future self. Something like a diary. I was writing it down. This is my current situation.
Yeah.
And dear future self, I hope that, also like you say, like, I hope you live a better life.
Yeah.
And please don't forget all the hardships that I went through to get you to the point that you are.
Yeah.
Something like this.
I thought about it a lot, but I didn't write it down.
Okay, okay. So you're like mainly thinking about it. I actually wrote it down because I looked at some diaries that I had because I'm cleaning out some stuff for moving. So this was one thing that I saw. And actually, when I think of my current self now, sometimes I think back to my past self and I see like these are two different characters.
Yeah.
But still, sometimes when I think of my past self, I'm like, okay, I will not forget you and don't think that you're a different person from myself.
Okay.
Or something like this. I don't know. I really found this topic interesting, but I don't think you do something like this in general.
No.
You're living in the moment, I guess. Which is also good.
Just a moment.
Maybe it's better. Yeah, I often live in the moments, but sometimes... when I cannot sleep because of my neighbors, I think about this.
And there we are again at the neighbor topic.
Yeah, the neighbors are back.
And now it's Neona's neighbor's turn to not sleep.
Yeah, your poor neighbors.
Sorry.
Yeah, I think it's not that bad.
It's not that late.
Yeah, it's not that late and you don't hear that much.
That's actually good.
Yeah, so I think I never heard my neighbors before. So in this room.
Mm-hmm.
So Neona, I met him outside, but never heard him.
So Neona, when I cannot sleep this night, I will just go to your guest room.
Yeah, it's very quiet, yes.
Nice. Just leave Meg at home, just like, you deal with the neighbors. Go to Neona. Yeah. Okay, let's continue reading and flirting with each other.
Yep.
Going through everything that we already read.
Wet. Let's see.
Is this
sorry?
The first time?
Okay.
<Ooh.
clears throat> 5 minutes passed until Martin left his hiding spot because it was too quiet and he got bored.
Kurt, are you there?
He hissed.
We really should get out of here.
Am I Paula now? Or?
Whoever wants to be.
Like, how many characters are talking here?
Only three.
So I'm still Kurt also, right?
Yeah.
So should I do Paula then?
If you want to.
Yeah, I can also try you.
I can also try Paula.
I can also try Paula. Paula.
So then try your Paula.
Hello there, fellow human. What are you doing here?
Paula asked cheerfully, and he spun around after she had seemingly materialized out of nothing.
I'm not human. And neither are you.
What?
I'm not human, and neither are you. Martin said... and stepped away from Paula. Since she was about the same height as him, it was difficult to guess how old she was. Her green eyes sparkled with confused anger.
I am human!
If I cooked you, you would have tasted like a human.
Behind his back, he reached for something to defend himself.
Death plant.
Okay, this would have been better. People usually didn't react like that when a stranger appeared in their home. Her reaction scared him. He had to admit to himself.
I sure hope so.
She replied, once more cheerfully, and noticed the silver spark behind him when he reached for the handle of the knife closest to him.
I would have chosen, like, the death plant.
Yeah. She caught his wrist and gave him an electroshock, which knocked him out, and he fell to the floor with a shriek.
No!
No, that's not you. Ah, yes, that is you. Sorry.
Paula stands. No. Like, Paula stands. Paula stands like a queen in this room, just like, no, it's not your turn. Go into your room. Okay. So, after Kurt got rejected once more, he's he shouts, no!
A soft sound escaped from underneath the kitchen table. So it's more like, no,
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 not him.
Kurt watched long girl legs covered by a blue dress stop closer and closer and closer and stop in front of him. Paula leaned down and her blonde curls covered her face.
You're the neighbor. How are you?
Kurt jumped and hit his head on the table.
Not so good. You have taken some stuff from my house and I would like to have it back.
He said and stared at the knife in Paula's hand. He felt sick.
Mindy has taken it.
Paula explained calmly.
Would you please give it back? Sure, have a seat on the chair.
Kurt carefully crawled out from underneath the table. Meanwhile, Paula started to collect all the stuff Mindy had stolen and placed it on the table. Pots, pans, forks, and all sorts of other objects.
And like all of the furniture.
Yeah.
Everything.
Then she brought Martin, like he weighed nothing, and set him on the chair opposite of Kurt. He was unresponsive. Kurt carefully touched his wrist to feel for a pulse.
So, you see, they are going to drink coffee. Like I predicted.
Oh, true. Last time you predicted that they are going to drink a coffee.
Maybe it's also tea.
Okay, so this is, I think, the closest prediction that we ever had.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Paula still put more and more stuff on the table. Kurt didn't even notice that some of the stuff wasn't his because he couldn't take his eyes off Martin.
I was actually wondering about this, if Paula actually knows what Mindy stole. And she's like, I
from
don't
where?
Care.
Maybe she's not sure on from where she stole it.
Where? Okay. Martin?
He whispered almost inaudibly.
Please wake up.
Suddenly, the criminal jolted awake.
Criminal.
I'm awake.
He announced before he looked around in confusion.
Are you all right?
Everything hurts.
He blinked a few times, shook his head, ran a hand through his hair. His body felt like he had just been run over by a truck.
I've been better.
Will you behave now?
Paula asked, threateningly, with a wide smile.
Yes, of course.
Martin said.
I'm so sorry I made you come here. He did not make him come there.
Kurt whispered.
It was Martin.
Yes.
Kurt, why are you apologizing for something that you did not do?
Kurt whispered as soon as Paula had left the room again to bring back a lamp and a chair.
Don't worry. It wasn't even your idea.
He touched his hand for a moment before he got distracted.
Hey, look, a diary.
He grabbed a pink book filled with silver gel pen writing. Martin opened it swiftly and Kurt glanced over to him.
Oh, wait.
Yep.
There's a diary. I talked about a diary before.
Yeah, oh yeah, God. I also forgot. Just
we have this episode is so good.
It's cursed. Yeah.
It's cursed.
The cursed episode.
Everything that we talked about will happen.
Oh,
so
no.
No.
Oh, no.
You didn't predict any money for us or something like this.
I like that you're actually thinking about this. Leona's just like, give me money now.
Yeah.
So, now we're going to read Mindy's diary.
Isn't it Marcy?
Damn it.
I already read it.
Yeah, it's okay.
And I don't have pink diaries.
Of course not.
That's Marcy's handwriting. It's rather boring,
Paula said.
Now get out of here before Mindy comes back. She is sometimes a little violent, but she is really nice. She is probably eating a lot of chocolate by now.
Martin was almost out of the door as soon as she said that.
Just like, okay, bye.
But then he went back to help Kurt stand up and collect his stuff. He wanted to hurry, but Kurt looked at Paula with something like pity. Martin would have wished for him to put Paula in jail, but then he assumed that he probably wouldn't because he missed his own daughter, who was only a little older than the girl.
Why would he like to put Paula in jail? What did she do?
She gave him an electric shock.
Oh.
You already forgot
the augment.
Yeah, okay, I was thinking about the whole bunch of stuff that Mindy stole, and I was just like forgetting about Paula. Like, she was nice enough to put everything down now.
That's true.
Kurt cleared his throat.
Where are your parents? Where are Mindy's parents?
Mindy's.
No.
Mindy parents.
Where are the Mindy parents?
Just like copies of Mindy. And play parents.
just a little bit taller.
Yes. And for the father with some...
mustard.
No, yeah, drawn not on the face.
Mustache.
Mustache.
Mustard on his face.
Like just draw it because she cannot afford pens or something.
With mustard.
With mustard. Very tasty with mustard.
Yeah.
I don't have parents, but I remember Mindy's parents. They were really nice before Jim accidentally killed them.
She pointed at the drawings on the walls.
And me too.
Because yeah, it was actually Paula.
Yeah,
actually. It was an accident.
Yeah, it was an accident. But it was Paula initiating this accident, actually.
Yeah.
I don't know if you don't remember what?
Probably not.
The plane crash?
Yeah.
The plane crash. And Paula was drinking the fuel or something like this from
the spaceship.
Mm-hmm. And Jim was like, no, don't do this. And then the fuel went out, mm-hmm. obviously. And then they crashed into the plane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then everyone died.
Yeah,
and it was very painfully. Fault here. Yes, very painfully.
Yeah.
Okay.
But now she puts all of the okay guilt on Jim.
Yeah.
Accusations.
Maybe she doesn't want to remember.
Yeah. Maybe she doesn't understand.
Yeah, I think she doesn't understand. She's also
or like, maybe oh, Jim sorry. Is like the terrorist groups who just say. They did something to get the attention.
Okay.
Yes.
Good. And shall we continue with the next part of the chapter?
Yeah.
Okay. The characters. Oh, wait. I think I forgot someone. Did I forget someone?
Yeah, there's just Miona.
Clara is missing.
Nee.
And
No. Clara, I don't have a picture of Clara because she is new. Mm. She is a friend of Trudy.
Okay.
Yeah. And
but there was not so much actually about Clara, right?
No, only that she had a school project together with Amber and she Amber and Clara spent some time together already and ate waffles at Walter's house.
Oh true, it was after Lisa got kidnapped?
Yes. And
Walter is very sad about it.
Yeah. And Clara tries to comfort Amber because she can tell how bad Amber is doing.
Yeah, because she's a daughter from Walter and Walter is not caring about her, you could say.
Yeah.
He's just like, give me back Lisa. And he does not care about Amber.
Yeah.
That's very sad.
That's really sad.
Yeah. Ah, what I wanted to write is Nuna news person.
I thought so. Yeah.
Okay.
The news person again.
Yeah.
The favorite role.
Mm.
6 degrees outside and the sun is shining.
Amber turned off the TV as soon as they entered the living room. She was concerned her father could be on the news again. She would like to not be embarrassed in front of her first ever friend.
Are you all right?
Clara asked. Amber nodded.
Wanna grab a snack before we go watch the movie?
Clara asked and opened the cupboards in the kitchen like she already felt at home at the cookie estate.
Hmm. There's only weird stuff, but no food. Now I'm actually curious what is in the kitchen.
Amber and Clara stood in the kitchen undecidedly when the door burst open and Walter marched in. He took off his lab coat, which had some dark red spots, and hung it neatly over a chair. With a sigh, Walter sat down and ran a finger over his golden wedding ring, his expression haunted.
Oh, does he... He's not thinking that Floopy stole his daughter, right?
He does not know. He doesn't know
he
what
does
his
not
daughter
know.
Is.
Okay, he's just sad that there's no Floopy.
Yeah, he said there's no Floopy.
No Floopy.
Okay.
Mr. Cookie, do you have any snacks we could smuggle into the movie theater?
Walter stared at her like he had only now noticed the two girls in the kitchen. Then he shrugged.
You can buy some there. I think I still have some money in the pocket of my order code. If not, I can quickly print some more.
He has like a 3D snack printer.
I think he means the money.
Oh. Yeah, I also think so. Yeah, I think also he meant the money, but it's also possible to print cookies with a 3D printer.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, if he has the right ingredients, you can actually make it.
Yeah.
Just program it. Thank you, but the whole point of smuggling snacks into the cinema is the smuggling part.
Clara explained.
I see. Let me think. I might have a gun somewhere.
How is he not in prison?
Walter said and thought about the last time he went to the cinema with
a gun. With the gun? With the gun? Yeah, just for a romantic date, I would say.
like the last time when he like put everyone else out of the hospital room, he's just like, in the cinema, I want to have like an intimate moment with my husband. And just like, everyone leaves the room!
Now!
Now! Or I shoot you with my gun!
They had watched a rom-com about cowboys, but Walter hadn't really been looking at the screen anyway.
Just playing with his guns all the time. This was not so intended as I...
Yeah.
I was not thinking about it before I said it.
Yeah.
I was just like, after I heard you laughing, I was like, oh, okay, damn it. This is what everyone tells me. No, not crying.
Clara.
Wait, how much money can you print and can I have some?
Clara asked and she followed him and Amber down the stairs to the lab.
Plop. Probably, yeah. Probably an infinite amount of money. If given an infinite amount of time, and also no.
Mr. Cookie!
Just call me Walter. I don't think I also have a snack machine somewhere.
I do think.
Oh.
Change the complete sentence.
I do think I also have a snack machine somewhere. I had to hide it because my husband ate so much snacks. I could no longer close the suit. I think we went... Ah!
Whoa.
Yeah, it's a bit dunkel for me.
Oh, sorry.
Right. I like when he gets cuddlier, but he got really upset about his suit.
Walter rambled on as he looked through the boxes in the lab.
If it's not here anymore, he might have found it.
He might have... Ah, okay, so Floopy has a snack machine at home, I guess.
Maybe. Clara picked up one of the family pictures placed on the work desk. It showed Lisa and Floopy at the playground.
Why are you not building a daughter finding machine?
Oh, I actually built one. Here.
He took a carton box from a shelf and grabbed a little platinum-colored screen with a green arrow. The arrow pointed at Amber and continued to point at her even as he moved it around.
Oh, okay, that's cool. And that doesn't work with Lisa?
She looked around the huge, dimly lit lab, trying not to show how astonished she was. Most machines and other weird objects were covered by white blankets, hiding them from the dust and curious eyes. Walter frowned.
No, the daughter firing machine can't read her data weirdly. I figured it out. Would you like to take the chocolate machine with you to smuggle the whole thing into the cinema?
Clara nodded.
Sure. Like the whole machine. How does she smuggle this one?
Underneath her pullover.
Nice.
Yeah.
I actually like this attraction here. He's just like, no, but you can have this one. Okay, but it's weird that the machine does not work on Lisa. Maybe because he built it after Lisa got missing and, I don't know, the machine has to work like with the original data of the daughter. And because Amber is there, he could maybe, I don't know, get some data, like, I don't know, fingernail or hair or something. Mm. Put it into the machine and the machine is like, okay, I find the daughter. Mm. But no, Lisa's not there.
Yeah.
So. Or maybe there's another reason.
Hmm.
Sam is just like, yeah, we'll read the next one.
He's also adopted.
I mean,
yeah. Amber and Lisa Amber are both. Also.
Yeah, Amber and Lisa, yeah. Like, okay, they are the kids from Walter's sister.
Yeah.
So what? His sister died.
Ah, true, this was the story.
It's so complicated.
Yeah, it really is.
Yeah, so we always have to introduce a little bit of backstory just to say what happens here.
So Walter's sister is called Phyllis, and Phyllis was married to Bruno, and they both had two daughters, Lisa and Amber. Then Phyllis went through a portal and got eaten by an octopus. And before that, Bruno divorced her for reasons, I think. But they were divorced at the point when she died. And then Walter and Floopy took the kids.
Maybe they were never married. This also happens.
Perhaps. Could be. There's one last part. I think we can just read it.
Okay.
Since we didn't chat at the beginning as much.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, Bruno and Floopy. I like how they look. They are like, ugh. I don't want to live anymore.
Okay.
I like that Bruno's description of Phyllis' ex-husband. And just like father.
Yep.
Floopy's description is also quite nice. At first, a random dude on a park bench who feeds the birds but has a complicated backstory and relation to the other class of characters.
Yeah.
And is one of our favorite characters. I love Floopy.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to speak Floopy. Nice!
Yeah.
And you're going to speak Bruno.
Yeah. Seven vacant bottles lay scattered amidst the lush green grass adjacent to the cabin. This picturesque scene unfolded near a serene lake nestled in the heart of a dense forest. The bottles, like forgotten treasures, lay undisturbed, adding an intriguing element to the peaceful ambience. Floopy assumed they used to hold cheap wine. He had been walking through the forest for hours before he had arrived at the cabin. The cabin sucked.
Okay.
When did you write this? Immediately after the Kurt chapter?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because it has a similar feeling.
In a flowery mood. Okay. There's the little cabin. It sucks.
Why does it suck?
It's stupid. Stupid cabin.
You don't like cabin? Floopy doesn't like them?
No.
Aww.
At the base, holding a fishing rod, sat a brown bear that looked quite familiar.
Bruno?
Floopy?
I haven't seen you since the funeral.
Bruno turned back to look out onto the lake.
That was on purpose. I just want some peace.
Floopy took a little plush octopus out of his pocket and stepped closer. He wanted to say something, but Bruno interrupted him.
Don't. You're scaring the fishes. Let's go inside.
Go.
Bruno stood up with a groan, staggered to the cabin door, and gestured for Floopy to follow him, who reluctantly obeyed. On the inside, the cabin looked even more depressing than on the outside. Wait. outside. Damn it.
On the inside, the cabin looked even more depressing than on the inside.
Outside.
Very, very depressing inside. I miss Phyllis.
Too.
It is hard to lose a partner. I don't know what I would do if I lost Walter. I fought in the war. But have you considered just not being depressed?
Such a floopy thing to say, isn't it?
But have you considered just not being depressed? Yeah, just don't be. Sam, as just I told you happy. In the beginning of the last chapter, just don't be depressed.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Just that I have a mood.
This is such a depression-free zone and everything that we write is full of depression. Why? Why can't our characters be happy?
You've been living in the ivory colored house, living your best life. Don't pretend you've been suffering like me.
I wasn't even.
You sit in the pretty house with your pretty husband, drink champagne every day.
We don't have to be enemies,
Floopy suggested. his bear mask, hiding his expression.
Like Bruno also has a bear mask, right?
Underneath his own bear mask, Bruno was fuming.
I've never been like you. Don't pretend like you care.
The absence of anyone to watch them provided a rare opportunity for the two men to confront the truth of their animosity. The pretense of liking each other had become tiresome, and now they could no longer bear the burden of containing the facade.
I like that you put like in this sentence, there is a pretense of liking each other. Like, oh yeah, two families, they should like each other. And you're like, bear?
Yeah. Bear the burden of maintaining that facade they had kept for many previous years. With no one to witness their true feelings, they were free to express their contempt openly.
Okay, wait. Huh? Why assumption?
Yeah.
Floppy does not like Bruno because he's wearing a bear costume he does not like. They have different tastes and opinions on like bear costumes and what material they should be out and how they should look like.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Floppy and Bruno have completely different opinions, and they got into a fight of this before.
Mm-hmm.
And they were not able to resolve this.
Mm-hmm.
And since then they have a grudge to each other.
Okay. Sure, why not?
Could be.
Could be something completely different, but I think this is how they feel.
Okay.
You're right. I don't. This place is hideous, by the way. You should decorate the cabin. Here are some dead plants and this.
The cabin is decorated.
Something I noticed. I still think telling someone their house sucks is such a sick burn.
This is really mean if you say this.
Yeah.
Because for a lot of people, their house is like... or something like this?
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you remember little Sam who wrote Trudy saying that Gordon's house.
Yes.
This is just something that stayed with me. I noticed earlier, but I didn't write it on purpose this way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting.
But you don't go openly to other people's house and like, you should do this differently.
I mean, they are not...
I think you think it, but you don't say it out loud.
Those are not outward thoughts, yeah.
Hey, that's one of Lisa's friends.
Floppy pointed at one of the dusty pictures on his equally dusty desk.
I like that Bruno is also everything is dusty.
The girl with the hazel brown and curious eyes looked sad as she sat on the floor with ragged clothes. There were pictures of other sad children as well. Floppy counted at least 20.
Why is this so sad? Everything is sad here.
I'm sorry.
Everybody dies, everybody's sad, so...
They have a grudge because of the costumes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I cannot bear this any longer. No. Okay, so Floppy is... this cabin belongs to Bruno, so he lives in this cabin, right?
Yeah.
And he has a lot of pictures of Mindy there.
Not a lot of pictures of Mindy. One picture of Mindy, but other pictures of other children.
Ah,
starting to see what I did and why I changed one thing in the original first season book.
Oh, was it actually what you planned to do?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Then I don't like Bruno anymore.
Okay.
I'm not a big fan of her anymore.
Okay.
Because she changed something in the season one. Which I'm not going to spoil here.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting.
Why did you play dumb then? You were planning this all along. You evil child.
I like how you cannot tell when I lie, but I know every time you lie.
I normally don't lie.
Yeah.
Because I'm bad at it, I just don't try.
Wait, we'll often not believe you.
What?
Is she? What a coincidence.
The room seemed to shrink as the simmering hatred filled the space, creating an almost suffocating atmosphere.
Or maybe it was the bear suit.
It was a moment of reckoning, where they could no longer hide behind pleasantries and had to face the reality of their mutual disdain. Floppy crossed his paws.
You had a different family, didn't you?
Well, I suppose there's no point in denying it anymore. You're right. You always were used to have a different family. Sorry.
Yeah,
I didn't see the eye.
Yeah, it's okay.
You're right. You always were. I used to have a different family.
I knew it.
Congratulations.
Bruno glared at him.
I needed the money.
You were cheating on Phyllis.
So what? Lisa's not my real daughter, either.
Whose daughter is she?
Then that's why it's maybe not working because... Yeah, that's something like I was also thinking before. That they maybe not have the same parents, but...
Oh, no.
And Walter didn't know.
So, wait. If he assumes... The only assumption that he has is that Lisa and Emma are the daughters from Phyllis and Bruno. So the machine needs the information from Phyllis. But if Lisa is not Bruno's daughter, and maybe also not Phyllis' daughter, who's that? Whose daughter is she? Who the hell is Lisa? Okay, this is an interesting question here. And therefore, he cannot find her.
Yeah.
Because all of the DNA, I don't know if he has like Phyllis' DNA somewhere lying around in his lab, as you do.
Normally, what else?
What Walter normally does. So, interesting, okay.
Bruno took another swig from his bottle before he replied.
Phyllis made her on her own, in her lab.
Oh my gosh, she's a made human. How does it say, an artificial human?
Mm.
I think we talked about it once.
We talked about it and...
2 years ago.
We talked about it 2 years ago. Mm. And you really wanted Lisa to be artificial.
Yeah,
in some way. And I told you I really wanted Amber to be real. And this is what I settled for.
Nice, nice. What about Amber?
He stepped backwards.
Amber is normal. She is my daughter. She is my eyes and my ability to... to fuck up wherever she touches.
He threw the bottle against one of the wooden walls and it shattered.
Look at you, almost drowning in self-pity.
Floopy said.
Have you ever considered just not being sad? Not being sad and depressed and drinking some juice.
Juice.
I've invested so much in the local fish market.
He pushed the table over and scattered the documents, pictures, and office materials on the floor.
You are insane, Bruno, and a horrible bear. A disgrace. I hate your costume.
I mean, it goes in the direction, doesn't it?
Just doing some self-interpretation here. Yeah.
Bruno took a deep breath before he staggered closer.
You will never tell anyone the thing about Lisa, the thing about the fish market.
The mask almost touched.
Or the thing about my secret family.
I won't.
Floppy replied, his paws defensively.
But why were you telling me those things?
You wouldn't leave me alone otherwise. Why are you here, Floopy? Just to torture me? Again?
He hesitated. Glass shards were sprinkled on the floor, and for a moment he considered picking them up. But then he decided against it. He was tired of cleaning up other people's messes.
I may be in trouble. We may all be in trouble.
Why?
I might have lost Lisa. I think she got kidnapped by someone else.
Oh, no.
Yes, oh, and that's it.
No.
Good.
Nande, why?
Are you actually crying?
Yes.
Okay.
There's too much going on here.
Sorry.
I cannot bear this anymore.
Okay.
So, something happened in the past between Floopy and Bruno.
Yeah.
We don't really know.
What?
And Floopy kidnapped Lisa first.
Yeah.
And now Lisa got kidnapped again.
Yeah, but not by Walter.
But at some point... Okay, we know in future that Floopy will find Lisa again.
Yeah.
And none of the other characters.
Yeah.
So there will be a side story of Floopy finding Lisa again.
Mm-hmm.
But how does he know that Lisa got kidnapped? If she just vanished. Like, did the kidnappers, what? Like, tell him, yeah, give us a ransom money or something?
Maybe, I don't know. It's your turn now. I'm done.
Ah, it's my turn, right? Oh no, I have to continue the story.
No, you're maybe
you wrote so much.
Hmm? Yeah, maybe he hided her somewhere and she's not there anymore. That's why he assumes that she got kidnapped by anyone else.
But he can also say, like, she escaped.
Yeah, but maybe it was escape secure, so you really couldn't escape.
So it's a high security prison in his cellar.
Yeah.
In contrast to the low security prison that we have in the story.
Yeah, of course. There also has to be somewhere high.
This basement is, like, maybe Martin should be in his basement. Okay.
I mean, you can do with it whatever you want, but in my head I was also like, Lisa is not the type of person. It's not in her nature to just run away.
Mm. Especially if she understands. Maybe she got distracted by something.
Nah.
I think
do with it what you want.
Okay. But maybe we can already think about something that could be happening, like some ideas.
Mm. What about fish market with Polo?
The fish got extinct this country.
Yeah.
And fish got illegal because there's some kind of thing with not getting fish from other countries or something like this. Therefore, it's illegal to get fish.
Yeah, but
why? But Bruno is doing this illegal work, actually.
Ah, okay.
Amanda was like, he invested in it before it got illegal. And then he lost a lot of money.
Yeah, but he's still doing it.
Okay.
But together with Mindy.
Yeah. Okay. So what kind of... We have so many, like, strings of the story here.
So many open threads.
The first thing is we have no Lisa.
Yeah, and you also have to go back to Trudy and Gordon.
Yeah, I think you have not included the main characters from season 2 at all.
I hate them, I don't. I just want them to be there.
Completely disregarded here. Yeah, okay, we have to include them. Maybe they have something to do with Lisa. This would be interesting to have, like, a connection there, like a side story of Trudy and Gordon and Lisa. And then they go on adventures.
Yeah, they wanted to make out in the forest and then found Lisa.
Oh, that's a good idea. That's great.
How about not? I cannot write making out scenes, no. I'm so bad at it. I get cringe whenever I write something like this.
Yeah, that's cringe.
I have to write gore and blood, and I can write something like this.
Then you have to overcome your
house cringe.
Overcome
yes,
the cringe.
Overcome yes. The cringeness. Okay,
I just do it.
Okay. Is this your wish? Is your wish that I write something erotic?
No, the wish is that Gordon and Trudy go into the forest to make out and find Lisa.
Okay.
I mean, they don't
can,
have
can
to
you write
get
this down
very far with the making out, but just maybe...
Depends how much they learn during the whole time.
Yeah, it really depends.
If we already read the chapter that Sam wrote.
Yeah, but...
Okay, I'm writing down ideas now. Yeah. So this is your wish.
Yes, this is Neona's wish.
Wishes. So now I'm writing a wish list. It will be very fun when I go back home and Meg opens my phone and just sees this wish list like, Trudy and Gordon making out. In the forest.
And then they found Lisa.
In the forest. You can already talk if you
want. Yeah.
I'm just writing stuff on.
My wish is that Rico meets his new friend. In quotation mark.
Okay.
He has a new friend.
Yeah, there was this guy we shipped Rico with. Trudy saw her brother talking to...
True, yeah.
Someone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is the part of the old story, where we include the old characters.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and now let's think about the stuff that is, like, on open end here. So, okay, we have Lisa. This will be solved with Trudy and Gordon when they find her.
Mm-hmm.
So they have to think of something, how she got kidnapped.
Yeah.
Maybe kidnap by herself or something like this.
Okay.
Cool.
And we have Mindy still in the chocolate factory.
Oh, yeah, you did. Yeah, okay. Oh, I think this will be a
problem. You can like to wait. Do your blood and gore stuff.
Yeah. Oh, I could wait to see.
Okay, where Michelle dies.
Oh, yes. This is super. Oh, yeah, burning her skin down from the melting chocolate.
What?
It was very fun when I walked with Sam to your apartment. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh yeah, Sam, did I tell you about yesterday? Yeah, I got new shoes and my feet hurt so much. And I had like, how is it in English?
Blood.
The skin of my feet peeled off. And there was so much blood flowing on my carpet and everything. And Sam was just like, what the hell is wrong with you? And I'm like,
what kind of shoes did you buy?
No, just new shoes, and they are hard in the beginning, and I walk
around. Never happens with new shoes for me.
Some shoes you have to, like, how's gold? You have to walk.
Not until your blood.
Yeah, it's on the back side.
Okay, I never do this until I bleed.
Yeah, I had no other choice. I was going through the city.
Okay.
So, talking about some, yeah. This was very romantic. There was not so much blood and gore, but you know already that there will be some in my chapters. And some romantic stuff, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe connecting it with this one.
I try to see a connection there. But
I can make a connection.
Okay.
I have so many ideas for this kind of stuff. Okay, so Mindy's in a chocolate factory.
Yep.
Walter. Yeah, Walter's there.
Yeah. The others are now going to the cinema.
Oh, yeah, they're going
Amber
to the cinema.
Amber and how was she again called?
Amber and Friend.
Amber
Clara.
And Friend. Ah, yeah.
And also important, which I did in the last few chapters, which I've been doing since season 2 started, Amber does not talk. She is too traumatized to talk. Mm. She never says a word. If you want to keep that going, okay. Or have at least a big reveal if she starts talking finally.
But I think she talked with Clara.
She did not.
But I think in one chapter she wrote.
No, she doesn't.
She just nodded or something like that.
She nodded. She points at things. Clara always only talks to Walter.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Then I have to go read. Back. You have to send me everything that you wrote so far.
Absolutely not.
How should I remember? There will be so many holes in the story when I cannot see what was written before.
Okay.
Send me everything, Sam.
I can put it in the Readsy account. Maybe then we can already go through it.
Yeah. Okay, I already have some ideas. I think best I can make...
Up on the go.
Up on the go. Only if you have more wishes I should include. One more wish free. One joint wish of both of you.
Do not kill Kurt or Martin yet. Not yet. Not yet.
But I can make them suffer, right?
You can make them suffer.
Okay, good.
Good.
Good. Your small Mindy shining through. But you don't have a joint wish apart from this.
No, don't think so.
No. Zen could do something cool. She has to escape. Yeah.
I have to make her to be a likable character more. She's just a meanie.
Yeah.
And kind of stupid in the story. She's just like tries to anger people.
Yeah.
Like the Zen that I had in my mind was more intelligent than everyone in the story. So.
True. Zen is still in the house.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just so that you don't forget about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's see.
You will see. And this is a throwback to the magpies. Yeah. In the chapter before, in the intermediate chapter, Floopy saw 7 magpies, and there's this nursery rhyme about magpies. 1 for sorrow, 2 for joy, 3 for a girl, 4 for a boy, 5 for silver, 6 for gold, 7 for a secret never to be told.
Mm-hmm. There's still a secret, right?
Yeah, Lisa is the secret. Floopy promised to never tell anyone.
Oh, okay.
So he will not tell. He won't be the one to tell if anyone else ever finds out.
I think Walter would find it very interesting.
Yeah.
If Lisa would be like not be a normal human being.
Yeah.
I think he would, like, party it. I was like, yeah! That's my daughter, man!
And if you paid attention, I used the numbers in each part of the chapter and I did use the words. So gold was the ring Walter was touching.
Oh, okay.
Silver was the knife.
Mm-hmm.
Boy from the hospital, girl Zen, and joy and sorrow were also there. And also here with the chapter numbers. 7 vacant bottles.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, I paid attention. 6 degrees outside. You didn't even notice. Shame on you.
No, I just thought it was very nice.
5 minutes.
Like, I liked the text font.
Yeah. Okay.
But there's so much going on. We cannot pay attention to every detail.
Every little detail. Every so detail. Many details.
I almost forgot half of the story until now.
Yeah.
That's so true.
Yeah. So I hope you put as much heart into it as I did.
Oh, no, not at all.
No.
You, like, your writing is already top. My chapter can only be funny.
Okay. And gruesome.
And gruesome. And you wrote a lot and I cannot write so much.
No, it's okay. It's fine. But I think we got a few chapters until we have to record again.
Yeah, or something.
Yeah.
So this is a lot. So maybe I can just make 1 or 2. Also depends on my...
schedule.
Inspiration.
Okay.
Maybe I get some inspiration during the night when my neighbors are playing with my washing machine again. And I get like 1 for sorrow, 2 for joy, 3 for gold, 4 for boy, 5 for silver, 6 for gold, and my secrets will never be told. My secrets.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think this is everything for this chapter, right?
Yep. Yeah. That's it.
Yeah. Very great job.
Thank you.
It was very interesting to read and very curious to see. Like, I really like this part where we are now trying to top each other, but this was already top of the top.
Thank you.
So I can just...
No point in trying.
Now it's pass or fail next time. You will look at my story like, no.
Nope, nope.
Don't do this. And Miona will also be a judge of this. No. Yeah, you should also write a chapter now.
Oh, no.
You can write the truth and God and see.
Yeah, I will send you the part. And you can, I think you can maybe write this one.
Okay, I can try.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes,
like when you're in your workplace, like you get a
notification.
Notification. Just like, yeah, please write the makeout scene now. They're like, okay, let's go.
But you also need me to tell me where it should end so that I can lead to this point. No, okay. So how they should interfere with Lisa somehow. So,
yeah.
This you need to tell me. So
there's just a part missing and Neona read the part.
Yes.
Okay, it has a beginning and an end.
Okay.
So you can write like they go into the forest and then they found a mysterious house or I don't know.
Okay. You can also put more stuff in between, whatever you like.
Okay.
Let your imagination run wild.
Yeah, we will see.
Tee-hee. Okay. So thank you, Sam, for writing.
Next time
you will see my horrible chapter.
Okay.
And
damn, it's part of me.
Like a combination of me and Miona.
Yes.
Woo. Yes. Woo. Let's go.
I look forward to it.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So thank you for listening. If you want to see more of us, we are on social media.
Yes, we are.
Where are we?
We are on Instagram.
Fiction After Lunch.
Tumblr.
Fiction After Lunch.
YouTube.
If you're not already there, Fiction After Lunch.
Twitter.
And Lunch, which is also called X right now. And you can also support us on Patreon and Ko-fi, where we also called Fiction After Lunch. If you want to support our... like,
stuff.
Please support Sam for her beautiful writing.
Thank you.
If you want to write us an email in a professional way, you can write us on fictionafterlunch@gmail.com.
Please rate and review wherever you can. This would be a huge help and we would really appreciate it. If you send us a screenshot of a 5-star review from wherever you could review and a prompt, Sam will write a 500 to 750 word story for you, which we will read on the podcast. Prompt can be from season 1 or 2 or a fan fiction if we talked about the series before on the podcast. Thank you for listening.
Okay, task for you, Sam. Now you have a lot of time.
Huh?
Learn this part by heart, please.
I will not. No, absolutely
not. Why
not? I will read it out because it's perfect this way.
But if you learn it by heart.
No.
No, no.
Okay. You can learn it by heart if you want. Then I don't have to talk about me in the third person.
I don't know why you even started it with your in third person.
Just to be clear that it's me who is right.
It's the me.
In case anyone gets our voices confused or such.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
If you don't know who is who at this point, then I don't know.
If
I think
you're
our
new
voices
here,
are quite distinguishable.
If you're new here, thanks for listening to this episode. And I'm Sam. Hi.
Good that you introduce yourself now. Okay, what should be our last sentence?
Oh, please read and review. I don't know.
I need the money.
Okay. I need some money.
Okay.
I need some money?
Yeah.
I needed some money.
Yeah, I needed some money.
Okay. So, thank you for listening. Hope you're joining us for next time.
Yep.
And 3, 2, 1.
I needed some money.